I am absolutely honored to be moderating the panel this afternoon. Typically, I get to work with the young students and our interns, but this kind of brings it full circle to sit here with you guys and talk about what you've done and where you've come and what you've learned. We have a series of questions coming in from students. What have you learned about working in retail that has surprised you?
How dynamic and multifaceted it is. But every day really is different.
Whenever I was going into this, oh, this will be great, this is glamorous, you travel all the time. And really, I think I had a lot more fun in the stores because you're around the same people every day. You're building your family, you're building your team.
When you graduate college, you're 22, and I stepped into my first store 2 weeks later, June 1st. And half my associates were twice my age. And you have to ensure that, you know, yes, they understand that you're the boss, but you also still want to be a friend to them. You still want to learn about their life and who they are as an individual.
What was the most difficult thing about your transition into the industry?
So many people are counting on you, and they really want to hear your opinions and your thoughts. But it's really a great feeling to know that you're part of a team and that people are counting on you.
I think the hardest transition for me was whenever I took my job with Belk, I actually moved 6 hours away from friends and family. So that was the hardest transition for me, was everything changing at one time. So I was used to college, I had roommates, I had friends, I had family nearby. Moving 6 hours away, you're completely alone and you're starting a new career, you don't know anyone. So really just getting out there and getting to know people was the most important thing for me.
Being a sales manager, our busiest times are Friday, Saturday, and sometimes Sunday. So, you know, for me, we work lots of weekends. It does take a toll on your social life, but, you know, you just really have to make a balance between work and life. And I know that's what Terry Lundgren would say, is he promotes really big work-life balance, and he wants you to enjoy yourself, but work hard at the same time.
What is your best advice about setting yourself apart from other interns or even other graduates trying to get that same position?
Every day is an interview. You're interacting with a lot of people in retail right now. So remembering how you're acting, what you're saying, what you're doing, that it's coming, it's sending a message. Not only are you interviewing for companies, you want to make sure that you're interviewing the company that you're going to work for. Is this a place that you're going to be happy? Because everyone wants something different. So make sure that where you go isn't just somewhere that you're going to be for a couple years because you're going to be looking for something else.
Even if you aren't happy, it doesn't mean it's not a great opportunity
right.
And you aren't learning something really important.
Absolutely.
And none of your jobs are going to be a life sentence.
Which class did you find most helpful in your new professional careers?
When I took retail math, that really helps me understand the entire industry, and it helps me understand why a certain item is selling and why the customer likes it.
Trend forecasting was a fun one.
Even more than the classes, it was learning how to interact with other people. So group projects are huge.
What would you do differently during college?
I wish that I would have gone to more career fairs, even as a freshman, a sophomore, instead of sitting back and putting it off and saying, that's for junior year, that's for senior year.
More than being a member of an organization, actually be involved in an organization, because I know a lot of people are like, oh, it's junior year, I'm going to join this club and not go to any meetings. get involved and start networking.
Know who you are and what you're bringing to the table, and don't be afraid to toot your own horn. You are special, you are different, and you are really good at things that people next to you might not be.
What is the one thing that has surprised you the most about the industry?
A lot of times you think about corporations and industries, and when you're going into the workforce, that it's going to be a little cutthroat. And it was not that at all. Everyone is very welcoming.
And going through college, I never really understood the wide breadth that it offered, and there are so many different positions, and there's something for everyone, and it spans from HR to marketing to merchants to store. There's such a variety within the industry.
What were some of those myths that you may have believed about retail? And I think some of you even started in retail and said, no, this isn't for me. And then a couple years later changed your mind.
I was definitely scared that it was going to be too competitive or too hard, or on the flip side, too boring and too canned. And none of that's true. You guys all have equal opportunity to do anything and everything you want to.
I loved how the panel was giving us real things that we learned in school.
There's so much to learn and grow from in the industry. It's great to kind of get her input as far as, you know, where to start and where to go and the day-to-day activities of that.
It's a constant learning experience, and it's an ever-changing environment. So, I mean, you're always improving, you're always learning something new, you're always changing the way you do something, you're always being critiqued, you know, positive, constructive criticism is always being given, so you're always changing.
There's so many different things to do and so many different elements of it, and it's all really exciting and really interesting, and it's just about finding your niche.